You should rejoice and be glad and thank God for your lives and for today as well, and the life of your family and everything around you in Jesus' name.
We want to thank you. We want to bless you. We want to worship you. We want to adore you because you are a good God. Great is your faithfulness. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we bless you. We honor you, we celebrate you as Lord of Lords. Thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. We adore you, God. We celebrate you, we celebrate you, we celebrate you. We say you are King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We worship you because great is your faithfulness, O God. Great is your faithfulness, great is your faithfulness, great is your faithfulness, O God. Great is your mercy, great is your mercy, great is your mercy, great is your mercy. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for our God, we worship and we adore you. Blessed be your name, blessed be your name, blessed be your name. In the name of Jesus, thank you for what you've done.
We are being deceived and the truth is not in us. His word says if we confess our sin, he's a faithful and a just God to cleanse us and wash us, purify us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Open up your mouth and bring your heart before the Lord. Tell the Lord to set through you. If there be any ungodly sin, anything that you've seen with your eye, any sin that you purposely seen, anything
in the name
that
of Jesus.
Before you, let us bring our heart before
the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we adore you, we honor you because you are good God. Thank you for your mercy that I live every morning. Thank you for your mercy that I live every morning. Thank you for your mercy that I live every morning. We worship you, God, for what you have done and what you have done to our life. We celebrate you, King of Kings. We celebrate you, Lord of Lords. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Makala.
In
the name Jesus. Thank you. God bless you. Shall we take our seats? We are very grateful unto God for another day. David said that this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. It's always a rejoicing when we come before His presence. Because in His presence there is fullness of joy, and at His feet there are pleasure for those who love righteousness. To them who love righteousness, there is always pleasure for them. To them who love righteousness, there is always pleasure. There is always pleasure, everlasting pleasure for them. Hallelujah. Shall we set our Bible into the book of 1 Corinthians, the chapter number 6? As we bring into conclusion our studies on the way all deceived. 1 Corinthians chapter number 6. We want to read the verses number 9 to 10. 1 Corinthians 6. Is anybody there? 1 Corinthians 6. Alright. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. We want to read the verses number 9 to 10. The word of God says, yes, please.
I read in Jesus' name. Do you know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God?
Don't you know that unrighteous people will not inherit the kingdom of God?
Do not be deceived.
Don't be deceived.
Neither fornicators.
Neither fornicators.
Nor idolaters.
Nor adulterers.
Nor adulterers.
Nor adulterers.
Nor homosexuals.
Nor homosexuals.
Nor sodomites.
Nor sodomites. Such people will never have parts in the glory of God. Such people will never have parts in the kingdom of God. The Bible is very straightforward. Bible does not play up with sin. As you and me are aware, it was because of sin that Satan was abandoned from heaven. And it is because of sin that every human being who is living on earth will be abandoned from heaven. Heaven is the place that God made for holy angels and for God Himself. Satan knows very well that the only way that he can cause humanity not to make heaven is to cause them to sin. There are different types of sin, but there is no categories of sin in the sight of God. There are different ways that people sin, but there are no different answers that people will have from sin. They will all get the same reward. Number one, he said that they will never enter into the kingdom of God. Meaning that they will never be a part of the future plans of God. God is waiting for a day that He will destroy Satan. And the destruction is not going to be like one day destruction, but it's going to be eternal destruction. The purpose of God towards sinners are very, very sad. Don't you know, that every person that conducts himself in evil manner will not make heaven? The word of God says that when we are tempted, we should not say that it is God who has tempted us. God has zero tolerance for sin. Say after me, God has zero God has zero tolerance for sin. Satan will let him feel that sin is weaknesses. Sin is your own weaknesses. And every person has weaknesses. Sin is not weaknesses. Sin is a shame thing that humanity can endure itself with. Another point, Satan will cause you to blame others. You begin to point fingers on others. Confronting the realities, you always have a excuse. And that excuse will be, it is somebody's fault. It is somebody's fault. It will never be our fault. Blaming others might give you a sense of relief. But I bet you, you are going to get a reward and a punishment thereof. You can blame others for your mistakes. That's fine. Somebody can weep for your mistake. That's fine. But you'll be punished. So stop allowing Satan to deceive you. That I'm mistaken. James chapter number. Sorry, 2 Corinthians 11 verse 3. 2 Corinthians 11 verse 3.
2 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 3.
But
I fear.
Somehow.
How the serpent deceived Eve by his craftiness.
How serpent deceived Eve by his craftiness.
So your minds may be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ.
So your mind be corrupted in simplicity. We have right to do everything, but not all of them are beneficial. Satan will lead you to believe in the grace. One of the deceptions is we are the grace period. My grace cover you. That even if we sit together, God will look unto me. And this is one of the deceptions of these fake ministers. They tell their victims, oh, because of me, God will forgive you. Taking a woman into a hotel and with a sense, with a little sense of awareness and consciousness, the lady said, "Pastor, it is sin." And that person will say that I have been led by the Holy Spirit. If a pastor tells you to sin with him or sin with her, and she or he is telling you that he has been led by the Holy Spirit, if you are a person with your right sense, does the Holy Spirit sin? No. So people who are being deceived had allowed themselves and positioned themselves in a situation where they can be deceived. Satan deceived humanity with a simplicity in God. And he will continue to deceive man. That even if God is not taken after we have been raptured, if God is not taken, God will bring us back here and ask Satan to deceive us again. In a millennium reign, God will release Satan again to deceive humanity. Because God wants to prove him that he is wrong. Ladies and gentlemen, to us who have come to know the glory of God, Satan tempted Jesus.
You must be trained how to convince people. I recently went to a shop. My intention was not to make a contract, but those guys were able to convince me to bind me to have 2 years contract. After we have finished it, I look at him and say, I see you people are using juju to convince me to do what I'm doing. They saw the product in such a way that I felt, oh my God, I finally got what I need. When I came home, my wife said, it's 2 years. Have you calculated all the money in 2 years? 60 times for 24. Are you going to pay this money? So for suddenly I became aware of myself. I said, oops. By the two ladies. However, when I complete what I'm paying now, the difference is not big. Secondly, also, the set, mobile set that they were giving unto me also is what I'm looking for. So I was convinced, I don't allow your wife to speak it out. It's fine, you've read it. Sometimes, we try to find some words to consolate ourselves. When we think that we have made a big mistake. But the point is, I wonder how these customer service, how they operate. They are very good. And that is how Satan does it. Christians, we need to learn how to sell our products. We need to learn how to sell Christianity to others. If you know how to sell it, we wouldn't make the same and people will come. If we know how to live our life in a well manner, that people that come closer to us will see that there is something different in us. There is something peculiar about us. When we stop blaming others, when we stop pointing fingers at others, when we stop saying that it's because of this. When Adam and Eve fell, the first thing that they did was blaming others. If it is not by the grace of God, to be honest with you, Adam didn't say he was sorry. Eve never said that he was sorry. None of them pleaded for guilty. Every one of them said, I'm not guilty. It is the woman. And the woman said, it is the snake. If there is anything that we should have killed, then it is the snake. And I believe the snake didn't jump just like a sonic. But he was able to acquire much information. Be very careful. Yesterday I was having the teachings and I said that be very careful the people that you open up your secrets. Some of you talk to any person. Even before the person you can become a very close friend, test him with little things. Test him with £5. If you remember to bring that £5, tell him that he's faithful. Test him with little things. Sometimes we trust people in such a way that we want them to feel happy and we will suffer. That's a matter. We want to be so kind and so good to people. It doesn't matter. And these people will just take you away and take you for granted. But there is a reward. Let's do everything with wholeheartedly. Even if people take us for granted, let's do it because that is what we've been called for. People will cheat on us, but don't work. They are cheating on themselves. If sinners know the reward awaiting for them, they will never stop. If people know what is awaiting for them, for the little lies, for the little advantage that we take on people, if people are aware of the consequences, I bet you, they will never trade with sin. Hallelujah. Blaming others. The Bible says, then after the desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full grown, gives birth to death. Don't be deceived. My dear brothers, every good and perfect gift is from God. Every good and perfect Amen. Satan will let you believe that everyone will go to heaven. It doesn't matter. There is nobody who is a sinner. All of us, we are going to heaven. There is no one who is a sinner. Revelation chapter 21, verse 27. Humanity who have gone to hell have been deceived. And people are still walking in the wrong way of deception. Satan will let you know. Heaven, we are all going there. There is one notorious fetish priest in Ghana. His name is Kwaku Bensah. Kwaku Bensah said he will go to Ghana. And he will go to heaven. And the faith pastors will come and meet him in a very close in the armpit of Jesus Christ. And he will slap people's faces. You see, when your heart is sinful, you think that even in heaven you can have the chance to slap someone. You see the mentality that people have towards heaven. If I am supposed to be in the heaven gate, oh, another day I will not open him to come in. Such mentality that you go to heaven. You wait. On that day, I will sit in the front of heaven gates. And I will shout out, none of these people will come in. These are some of people's thoughts. Because they believe that all of us are going there. Satan never thinks that he's going to heaven. He knows that he will never go there. But he is deceiving his people to believe that they will make heaven. Revelation 21, please, verse 27. Revelation 21, 27. Sheila, please read for me. Nothing unclean. And everyone that does what is shameful or deceitful. But only those whose names are written in the Lamb's book of life will be found there. Hallelujah. Say, if I live my life on cleanness, if I allow my mind to be filled of deceitfulness, I will not make heaven. Every one of us must know what will not make cause you to make heaven. As of now, if you are a Christian and you don't know what will cause you to lose heaven, I am afraid something is wrong with you. If you are born again believer, and you are still not aware of what will cause you not to make heaven, then I am afraid. How long are we going to be deceived? Nothing unclean. Nothing unclean. When God is saying unclean, it means that anything that has not right stand with God, anything that heaven doesn't approve, any lifestyle which is not coming from God, any decision which is not being endorsed by God. If your marriage is not being endorsed by God, it is unclean. If your job is not endorsed by God, it's unclean. I have my brother who is a leader of a church. And his job is to clean disco. His job is to clean where prostitutes go and work. So long as he's making money, I'm not getting money, I say you're blind. You are not doing it. But you are hiring people to go and clean that place and bring in money. Never be like this, that deception. Because people don't care that as long as I'm getting money. If you are a Christian, you can't work where they sell drinks and alcohol. You can't work at a supermarket where people come and buy alcohol from you. You can't. If you are a Christian, you can't trade with anything which is unclean. After you give it to people, you are feeding them in their sin. Let us be very cautious and careful with our love. What we call sin, we shouldn't promote it in any form. We can't promote sin. David, David, go answer that.
When he saw Peter and John,
When you give your attention to people that you're supposed not to give your attention to. You know when miracle takes place. When you give your attention to God. Whenever you expect something from people, you get it. The reason why people are being deceived. Their expectation is too high. But vary your expectation. Where are your expectations? Put them into a position and know that the expectation is going to be something fruitful. Fixing his eyes on them, expecting to receive something from them, Peter disappointed him and said,
then Peter said, silver and gold.
Silver and gold we don't have.
I do not have.
What you want, we don't have. But we have what you need. What you want, we don't have. Pastors need to have what people need, not what they want. We are not there to service people. We are not a room service. We are not a taxi driver that feed people and drop them anywhere. Silver and gold have we not. But what we have in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, what we have in the name of Jesus Christ in Nazareth, rise up and walk. They suffer their hands, and the man gave them his hands. And they were leaping and jumping. He was leaping and jumping. And he followed them into the church. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't let us give people what they want. They want miracle, but they need heaven. They want prosperity, but they need salvation. They want husband, but they need peace with God. They want wife, but they need eternity. People are running after things that will not satisfy their soul eternally.
Amen.
It's very sad. It's very sad when it breaks my heart. It's very sad when I see humanity following the line. The next line. You are the last line to be blessed. You are the last line to be promoted. Promoted to where? To heaven or to hell? Don't be deceived. If a person cannot promise you of heaven, if a person cannot give you assurance of heaven, run away for the soul that you need. One day you and me will come to the realization that all that we have wasted our life here is foolishness. Wasted, yes. You pray for the husband, you got it. But now you don't have home. You pray for the wife, you had it. But now you're not happy. What we have, we give in the name of Jesus Christ. Be careful that you don't allow men to deceive you. Satan will let you know that sin is alright. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 13. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 13. Every act of sin is deception. Every act of sin is deception. Understand that. Don't let Satan take you to where you don't want to be. Hell is not a place for your soul. There is no person that has gone to hell that wants to be there. Nobody. But there is no one blaming others over there because they know that it is their fault. Today, when you hear the voice of God, God, can you read for me, please? 3:13. Hebrews 3, verse 13.
Okay, Hebrews 3:13.
Okay. Are you there, girl? Encourage
Jesus has finished paying the price. Yes, it is true. But there is something that we also need to pay. We need to contribute. It's like coming to church. It is your tithe, my tithe. It is your offering and my offering that we will use to pay the rent here. So if you think that everything has been fully paid, you enjoy it and you don't care, that is not what God has called us into. The moment that we enjoy things for free, we don't give our heart for it. The moment we enjoy things for free, we don't put much effort in that. So Jesus Christ has paid the penalty for our sin. However, it is our responsibility to make our choices, to choose our choices very well. After that one, it has not been paid. Your choices has not been paid yet. You will pay for it. The price for your choice has not been paid. The price for your salvation has been fully paid. So for that one, you don't need to worry about. When you believe Jesus as your personal Savior, you are saved. But your choices is the price that you have to pay to maintain that which Christ has paid for you. There is a responsibility for us. So while there is a day, let no man deceive you. Let nobody deceive you. Don't walk in deception. Because deception has been the roadmap that Satan has dragged many people to hellfire. This world is not our final residential home. This world is a place that we rent. It could be a council house. It could be government property. You will never live there forever and ever. This place is not our final destination. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 13. Those who are deceived keep on deceiving others. One thing that you have to understand, that going close to people who have been deceived, be aware that you can also be deceived. Pastors today have been deceived to deceive others. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 3. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 3.
Unloving.
Unforgiving.
Slanderous.
Without self-control.
Brutal
despisers of evil.
Of good,
sorry. David, come here. Yes, please.
Traitors.
Hot.
Lover of pleasure.
Rather than lovers of God. Beloved, those who have been deceived will keep on deceiving others. Satan will let you know that lust, there is satisfaction in lust. Satan will let you know that there is satisfaction in gluttony. Satan will deceive you and bring you into a place of deception. But it is your responsibility to get out of that deception. Evil men and imposters will go from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. Evil men and imposters will move from bad to worse. So at the beginning, he was all right. Now, he has been convinced. And that conviction has led him far, far, far from God. A child of God, you must be able to identify the environment, the spiritual environment of your soul. If you are not, you are already condemned.
ministry is the moment people step here, the Lord will begin to change the situation in their lives. The Lord will begin to reveal things to them in a very profound manner. People begin to see reality of things. Hallelujah. The Lord shows us the amount of rapture experience today.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Now, tell them to stay out. Please. Please go out until we finish, yeah? Step out for us, please. You can see something. One thing that we must be aware. One thing that we must be aware is the enemy has so many ways of deceiving people. Come in now, please. Tell her, lock them out. We don't know who they are. Walk them out and close the door, please.
Sometimes you say the point that
Even it's not like you are telling people to encourage people, to want people to walk out of that lifestyle. You don't want to. Because you feel ashamed to relate to them. Apostle Paul said in the time past, when we were walking in our own ways, we were deceived. Satan is leading people into hellfire by deception. Matthew chapter 13, verse 22. We go back to our main scripture again. Jesus gave a parable. And in the parable, he gave us four different types of hearts. Different types of people that come to God. People who are searching. People who are just roaming about. People who are just inquiring, they want to know. People who are searching for the truth. They come to us every day. They come to us every day. Matthew chapter 13, verse 22, please. Amen. The one who received the seed that fell among the tongues is the man that hears the word of God. In this part, the worries of this life
and the deceitfulness of riches
and the deceitfulness of wealth, riches,
choke
it, and the word of God became unfruitful. Our life is life full of worries. There are so many things in life. If we allow them, they will overcome our victory. There are so many things in this life. If we allow them, they will ruin our testimony. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those who receive the word of God, they want to become born again believers. Truly, they have a sincere heart to follow after God. They have a sincere heart and a strong desire and a strong passion to go after God. But the desire to get money, desire to get wealth, desire to be rich. So, sister, you are going to stop this job. My little sister, she's a hairdresser. She finds it very difficult because I don't have any income apart from that. So if I stop this job, how am I going to live? The money will never be enough. The money, 10 millionaires, if they have enough money. So if we have what to eat, what to drink, what to wear, and where to sleep, that should be enough for us. Don't trade. Because of the pleasure, the husband is working all right. So I don't see any problem. Somebody haven't got even an income. Yet the person said that I will live, and the Lord is taking care of them. I am ready to go and hire a big house and house her and her children. I will do that if she wants to. But is she ready to go to heaven? If the gospel is vain, it's vain for those that the prince of this world has blinded. Satan will let you know that if you stop sinning, sister, how will you survive? You are going to stop selling this product. How is your family going to survive? They hear the word of God, but the deceitfulness and the pleasure of wealth. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to turn away. We need to turn away from deception. Now, how can I come out of deception? Number one, quickly. How can I come out of deception? Number one, we need to ask Jesus Christ to forgive us for our ignorance of the word of God. Because Satan is playing his tricks based So when a person doesn't know the word of God, beloved, that is the highest price. So we need to ask God to forgive us for being ignorant. We fail to study the word of God. We fail to read the word of God. And we fail to go to God. That is the highest ignorance. Instead of going to God and ask God. David, sit down. Instead of going to God to talk to Him, to avoid ignorance, ask for forgiveness, and stop doing things that have promoted your ignorance. Number two, invite the Holy Spirit into your life to show you the areas where you've been negligent, areas where you allow the enemy to rule your life with deception. You will need the Holy Spirit. Invite Him. Wisdom is that everything that you do, you follow only the counsel of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes our human wisdom are very, very, very deceptive. Invite the Holy Spirit. Don't take Him out. A child of God, the Bible said that as many who are led by the Holy Spirit, they are the children of God. Those who are led by the Holy Spirit. A child of God must be led by the Holy Spirit. Bring your conviction into prayers. Bring your decision of your choices into prayers. Ask God first. Say, Lord, have your way. Have your way. Number three, confess these areas of deception and sin and ask the Lord, confess them. Confess them. Confess them. Confession comes in two ways. Confession comes saying it or doing it. We've got the restitution. Bring back all that you have received, all that you are stolen from. Bring back to them. Bring back to them all that you have possessed wrongly. We've got the restitution. Confess. Restore any act of deception. Confess and restore. Number four, check yourself against any lies and any ways of deception. Check it. Sit down and check. Count them. Sit down, line upon line. Every mistake that you have made, I know. Every mistake that you have made, you know it. Every lie that you have lived in the past, and the one that you are still living, it comes to your memory every now and then. Repent and check them. Turn away. Renounce all the previous contacts with occult activities. Renounce them. Renounce every previous activity with contact with demonic spirits. Renounce every activity. Say it in your mouth in the name of Jesus. I refuse, I renounce, I reject, I set myself free from anything and the contact I have come into. Say it to yourself. Break it. That is how we break it. Speak it loud. Learn how to speak to the devil. It's how to get out of his hands. He doesn't want to let you go. If somebody is holding your hands and you want the person to leave you, how do you go about it? Do you struggle or tell him to leave your hands? Leave my hands first of all.